Did you know that veteran FBI agents, and yes, your potential borrowers, are looking at the same six signs to determine if you're reliable and what your future behavior may be? Welcome to this week's edition of Friday's Food for Thought. In his book, Sizing People Up, a veteran FBI agent outlines the six signs that help predict future behavior in individuals at your first meeting. And that is the case every time you step into a homeowner's house or you're meeting them face to face. They're going to be sizing you up to determine if they need to do business with you. So let's look at the six signs. Number one is vesting. Are you fully vested in their best interest? Are you actively listening to what they're telling you so you can help solve their problems instead of pushing a product down their throats? Number two is extremely important, one that we can often forget as HECM professionals, and it's longevity. Are you going to be there for the long haul? Do they get the sense that you're going to be available not only for a year or two, but maybe 10 years down the road? Or will you be there to answer their children's questions when they're trying to settle the loan if they pass away during the reverse mortgage? Third is reliability. That begins with keeping your promises. The first promise you should never break is arriving to the appointment on time. If you break that promise, it's going to be very difficult to establish or build trust. The other is your competence as a reverse mortgage professional. Are you not only well-spoken, but fully knowledgeable, and can you communicate the concepts about the HECM clearly? Number four is what you do, your actions. Do they inspire confidence or insecurity? Does it make the borrower feel that you're a professional, or maybe you're someone who doesn't really quite know what they're talking about? The pattern of what you do will really have a large bearing on your relationship. Number five is language. Especially with other professionals in the financial or accounting field, we have to be so careful about our language. Even today, there's terms that are being thrown around each week, and I see it online, that are actually inaccurate when it comes to describing the home equity conversion mortgage. So not only with professionals, but with homeowners, is our language concise? Is it accurate? And from a sales perspective, does it create an emotional connection? And number six is stability. How can you handle a strong emotional response from the potential borrower? Now, people are going to test you at times in the field during the sales process. It's all part of the game of sales. And if they find that they can push you around, or you react negatively or take it personally when they come at you with maybe a negative comment, or maybe they're even becoming a little bit more verbally aggressive, how you handle yourself is really going to determine where that relationship proceeds. Are you able to stay calm? Are you able to think strategically? Are you able to come alongside and build an alliance on a certain point and move past the objection? So your borrowers are not seasoned FBI investigators or agents, but they are, in fact, looking at the same six signs that determine your future behavior. Let us know your thoughts. You can leave your comments in the comment section below. You can share this with other reverse mortgage professionals using the social media links on this page. And don't forget, if you do watch YouTube, you can subscribe to our channel. Just click on the button right above this video screen. Thanks again for watching, and have a great weekend.